In the end, it wasn't even close.
Tonight, New Zealand has shown the Labour Party its greatest support in at least 50 years.
More than the Prime Minister could have hoped for.
We will not take your support for granted. And I can promise you, we will be a party that governs for every New Zealander.
The opposition leader gracious in defeat.
Prime Minister Jacinda Ardern, who I have phoned before, congratulations on your result, because it is, I believe, an outstanding result for the Labour Party.
Even if Crusher Collins was still displaying some of her trademark bluntness.
And I say to everybody, we will be back.
The result means it's possible Labour will be able to form majority government without a coalition partner, a first since proportional representation was introduced in the 1990s. As polls closed, journalists hungry for results were kept well-fed by Ardern's partner.
We've had such a long run with everything, so there's sort of a, I guess, a sense of relief that we're at this place now.
These voters were among the minority after almost 2 million New Zealanders took advantage of advance voting.
Yeah, I was looking forward to voting today. I didn't want to wait because you don't know what's going to happen in those 2 weeks.
In the end, they chose to give Ardern a second term, her victory never really in doubt. But it could all have been so different if COVID hadn't hit. Her go hard, go early mantra paid off. The virus more or less contained, the party's ratings back on the rise. It wasn't, of course, the only crisis the Prime Minister had to manage. She won hearts and minds for her response to the Christchurch terrorist attacks and the Whakaari White Island eruption. But she didn't deliver on many of her key domestic policy pledges. If that doesn't change, New Zealanders won't be so understanding next time around. Barbara Miller, ABC News.